Hello students, looking at current affairs for 15th April, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these four. Look at them in detail. The first one, PM extends lockdown till May 3, tougher restrictions at hotspots. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced on 14th April that the extension of countrywide lockdown would continue till 3rd May now. And there will be intensive containment measures at hotspots, which are COVID-19 hotspots, till April 20. And then if they will be qualifying for any relief measures and freedom of mobility based on the results. So he said the country should follow 7 steps. He said this is a new set of Saptapadi, which is traditionally a ritual associated with a system, a concept associated with Hindu wedding ceremony. So the new 7 steps or Saptapadi, which Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called people to follow, is: 1. To take care of elderly in your home, especially with those with comorbidities like other illnesses like heart problem or diabetes, etc. And because they are especially vulnerable. 2. To be vigilant in maintaining the lockdown and social distance. Use face masks. He encouraged using homemade face masks. 3. He said that follow the advisory issued by Ayush Mission. That is Ayush Ministry. The Ministry of Ayush is for Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. So medical systems. So he said advisories issued by Ayush should be followed to boost immunity. Then 4. He said download the Arogya Setu app, which is the Home Ministry app on the disease. So that has been asked to be downloaded. Please download the app and encourage others to do so as well. 5. Is try and help out the poor and indigent. 6. Be sympathetic to colleagues, avoid retrenchment, employers should avoid removing people from jobs. And 7th is accord respect and dignity to corona warriors like doctors, health workers, sanitation workers, police and others. So these are the 7 Saptapadis which Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called for. Then this is regarding the cases in the country. The number of recoveries in the country has crossed 1,000 now on April 13. This is the graph for recovered cases, and these are the new cases which have been recorded every day. So 787 new cases were recorded on April 14. Then next is Tel Tumde Navlakha surrender to NIA. So these are two people who are accused in the Bhima Koregaon riots case of 2018. So first of all, you should know what this Bhima Koregaon riots case is all about. So this was the Bhima Koregaon conference which was held, the Elgar Parishad conference, in December 2017. We have done this quite often. Bhima Koregaon battle was fought in 1818. So it was the British versus the Marathas, and British army comprised of the Mahar community, which had been employed as soldiers in the British army. So the Elgar Parishad had organized this conference in Bhima Koregaon to commemorate, and this is commemoration of the Bhima Koregaon battle, which happens every year. So it is on 31st December and 1st Jan that this is observed. So from 2018 became the second centenary year. So 200 years since the battle. So there was a grand celebration. And this every year, this results in conflict between and fights between the Marathas and the Mahar community in Bhima Koregaon, which is near Pune. So in December 2017, on 31st December, Elgar Parishad organized in Pune to commemorate contribution of Dalit community in Bhima Koregaon battle, resulted in speeches being given by various human rights activities, and these have been alleged to be provocative speeches. So on 1st Jan, there were clashes between the right-wing groups and Dalits on their way to Bhima Koregaon to pay homage at the site of the battle, in which one person was killed. An incident led to violent reactions all over Maharashtra. And then you can see these human rights activists have been arrested for organizing the Elgar Parishad and giving provocative speeches. So this is the Bhima Koregaon riots case, in which civil rights campaigner Gautam Navlakha has been arrested. He has actually surrendered now because the anticipatory bail pleas were before the Supreme Court, but Supreme Court rejected them. So that's why they have surrendered to the police. The case was earlier when BJP was in power in Maharashtra. Case was under Pune police, but later it has been shifted to NIA after new government was formed in Maharashtra in Jan 2020, and they have been charged under the Draconian Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. So this is the case. Mr. Anand Teltumbe, he is an engineer and IIM graduate who taught at IIT Kharagpur, and he is booked for alleged links to the banned Communist Party of India, Maoist. Then next is US approves two missile deals with India. So the US State Department has approved two potential missile deals with India for an estimated $92 million and $63 million. So the first deal is with Boeing for Harpoon Block 2 air launched missiles. These missiles can be fitted onto Boeing's PA-TI, Poseidon 8 India Maritime Patrol Aircraft, which have also been procured from US company Boeing. And so these will be air launch missiles now being procured from Boeing. And second deal is for torpedoes, lightweight torpedoes. So these torpedoes are also expected to enhance India's submarine warfare capability and can be used with the maritime patrol aircraft PATI. So Indian Navy already operates 8 PATI long range maritime patrol aircraft, which have been procured in 2009 for a $2.2 billion deal. Then in 2016, Navy exercised an optional clause for 4 more aircrafts in a deal worth $1 billion. So the first of the four aircrafts was to be delivered in May 2020, but this timeline will be delayed now because of COVID-19. The total deal is expected to be completed by Jan 2022. Means all 4 PATI, additional PATIs, would be delivered to India. So here you should know that USA is the largest trading partner of India in terms of defense partner. So USA has overtaken Russia, Israel and France to become India's largest arms supplier over the last 4 years. So various deals, you see, worth over $10 billion have been signed with US since 2007, now much more. It's still old news. So you can see Apache attack helicopters. Then we have had C-17 Globemaster III aircrafts, which, you know, strategic airlift aircrafts, howitzers, M777 ultralight howitzers, which have been, you know, deal has been signed with USA. Then heavy lift helicopters like Chinook. So these are all procured from USA, and this is regarding the PATI. So this is regarding the news regarding 4 more PATIs which were ordered in 2016. This is at that time. So you can see the 4 PATIs will add to the 8 ordered for $2.1 billion in 2009. Then the last news is world economy to contract by 3%, IMF. So International Monetary Fund comes out with its report, which is called WEO, World Economic Outlook Report. So the last WEO report came in Jan, and now the one which has come out in April, it says that world economy is to be contracting. You can see the world economy is expected to contract by 3% in 2020, much worse than the 2008-09 financial crisis. So this is going to have a severe effect. COVID-19 will have a severe effect on the world economy. India's growth is also expected to dip to 1.9% in 2020, and this, you can see, is contract by 3%. Means it will go in the negative if you look at the image here. So world economy is going to go at minus 3%. So it is going to contract, and India's growth will be 1.9%. So this is in the positive, 1.9% in 2020, and India will rebound to 7.4% growth in 2024. China is also projected to grow at 1.2% in 2020 and 9.2% in 2021. So these are the projections. Emerging Asia is projected to be the only region that grows in 2020 at the rate of 1%. Over average is 1%. India is 1.9, China is 1.2. And this is still 5 percentage points below the previous decade's average. This is the IMF forecast, World Economic Outlook forecast. This is that. So here you can see even advanced economies are going to take a negative of minus 6.1% growth in 2020. average global economy is at -3%, and emerging markets developing economies overall will also be in the negative at -1%. East Asia is the only region, you can see emerging Asia is the only region that is projected to grow in 2020. So that is it. Thank you.